Hi, this is Michael Hayter from Expanse VR, and this is the first in a series where I try to demystify the magic that is Shadergraph. And displaying here in Unity is the health or mana globes that you will be assembling by the end of this series. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and of course click that notification button down below to make sure you are notified whenever I post a new tutorial for you. So before we jump into Shadergraph, I think it's really important for new users to understand exactly what a shader is doing. All you need to know is that there are two main components to every shader, and it starts by the objects in our scene passing their vertices into the vertex shader portion of our shader. This then processes them into fragments, which are passed into our fragment shader portion of our shader. And not that it's too important to know at this stage, but both these components, so our shader, is processed by the GPU. And the final result is pixels being outputted. Now, there is a little bit more to it than this, but for the sake of these series of tutorials, it's all you really need to know at this stage. So if we jump into Blender here, it can help better describe what was happening in that diagram. This is a typical 3D object, in this case just a quad, a very simple object. And the components that make up the primary part of our object here are our vertices. These are the building blocks. And what the first part of our shader, our vertex shader, is doing is actually just manipulating these points to deform our objects. And as an example, for instance, say our fragment shader was manipulating this particular vertex, it would allow us to move it around and manipulate that object. Another good example is if I just do a quick extrude of it here, it'll come out a little bit. Say this was a tree in your scene. Quite often what you'll see in a game is that to mimic wind, you'll use a vertex shader or the vertex portion of our shader to manipulate our object and make it look like it is swaying back and forth. The second part of our shader is the fragment shader portion, and as you saw, the fragments were just all the bits that lay in between our vertices. And this is where, for instance, this plane here would be one section of it, and this is simply where we're adding our color. So jumping back into Unity, very important to know that Shadergraph only works in the universal render pipeline or the high definition render pipeline. And for the sake of these tutorials, we are just gonna be sticking to the universal render pipeline. There are a few nodes in the high definition render pipeline that don't work in the universal render pipeline, but we won't be covering them at this point anyway, so we're not gonna be really missing out on anything. So if you go into a folder and we're gonna create our first Shadergraph, you simply right click, create shader, and when you come down to this here, you'll see there's a few different graphs that you can pick from. We're predominantly going to be using an unlit graph. Simply put, it's one of the most basic ones, and it's going to do everything that we need for the time being. Now, for a shader to work, for a shader graph to work, we need a material assigned to it. And the easiest way to do that is on your shader graph, is to right click, create material, where are we, there we are, and simply drag it onto your object. And there we go, it's assigned. And to open up our shader graph, all we need to do is double click on it, and it's gonna bring us to this window here. So if we look at our shader graph, there are three main components that first pop up when we open it up. The master node, and in this case it's the unlit master, so it lets us know what sort of shader it is. We have our main preview, and this is just going to preview what's happening with our master node. And we have our shader graph properties window up here. Now this one here, we're not going to use that much for the moment. So you can just make this nice and small. And as you can see, if you grab the bottom right hand of this, you can change it. You can also move it around by simply left clicking on it. Same with the main preview one. This can be shrunk or moved around by simply clicking the top. For the moment, we're going to keep the main preview there. It is quite useful. We will change its layout of how we want it to look later on, but just leave it as it is for the moment. Going back to our master node though, and remembering what we said about the vertex shader part of our shader and the fragment shader. So these top three components here are what make up our vertex shader, and the bottom three are what make up our fragment shader. So we're not going to be focusing on the vertex part of it for the moment. We're simply just going to be doing on the fragment shader because it's a little bit simpler and a little bit more easy to work with initially. Now, if we want to see something straight away, what we're going to do is simply click on this point here, which brings up our color picker. We're going to change it to a different color. And as you can see, it's already been reflected in our preview window. Close it down. But as you can see in our actual game scene, it's actually not being reflected. It won't be reflected until we actually save the asset. Now, if you don't have a big enough screen to be able to see all this, well, the other thing you can do is actually drag this down to here. So you can just see that. I just grabbed it from here, dragged it down. And we're going to give ourselves some more room to play with. So this way we can see our scene and we can see our game display. We're also going to change this to one column layout. So again, give us just that little bit more room. For the most part, we're not going to really need the console for this, but we'll just keep it there anyway. So now we've got a bit more real estate to work with. So there we've actually done a little bit with our shader. But let's add our first node to actually start getting a better idea of how this actually connects all together. So we're gonna create by clicking, you right click, create node. And with this menu here, you have two ways of actually picking a node. You can actually go through this menu system and find the node you want, or you can simply search for it at the top. For us, we're just gonna look for the color node, enter. And to hook this up to our master node, all we do is left click on the out point, drag it over to the input point, and away we go. And same thing as before with the color picker, you can just left click on it and we can pick a different color. Again, you can see it's being reflected in our main preview. And once we click on save asset, it will be changed over. And that's pretty much it for this episode. The only other thing I'm going to quickly touch on is before we go is the knowing what's going on here, how we see the four here on the output and three here on the input. This is telling us how many channels of information are being connected. So for our color node, it's four channels of information, the red, green, blue channel, and our alpha channel. And our color node is taking in three channels, the red, green, and blue. We'll go more into that into the next episode, but that gives you a good idea of where we're at now. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and share to help grow our beautiful Unity community. And don't forget to hit that subscribe and notification button below to make sure you get to see our next video. See you shortly.